All right, today I'm gonna show you how to adjust the clutch on your Super Bird. But before I do that, I'm gonna tell you a little story. Back when I was messing around with 2K and trying to get it to work right, it was a constant cycle of basically this.
Он так не доедет.
А ты же, сука, череп.
Ему надо... Снимай запаску.
Coming in every day, and oh man, it was tough before I came up with the auger. Anyway, moving forward a little bit later, I got a hold of some nice brand new blackbirds, and I built them all up for 4K and sold them very quickly. And about a couple of months later, I think it was three of them. It was like three out of five that were just started to malfunction, and these guys were just all over me like, hey, what's wrong with my gun? What's wrong with my gun? What's wrong with my gun? I'd never seen this before. But turns out what happened is the metal plate right here was actually burning into this gear. And so I had to come up with a solution to get these guys going again. So the solution was to just go ahead and burn it out and countersink a brass washer. So I've done that ever since. And now I lubricate them with chapstick, actually, because it stays in there really well. But you might come to a point where you need to service your clutch. So what I did, even before the washer modification, was you have two of these little teeth on here, one on this side and one on the other. Now I shaved these down almost all the way, because if you don't, they'll just kick BBs off the auger with this big motor and the high voltage. You can run them completely shaved down or without the BB shaker. I just found it to be a little more reliable if you have something there to shake it a little bit. So, where was I? That mod, before the metal washer, was to drill a hole under one of these little teeth, ears, whatever you call them, the same diameter as this 12 gauge needle that you get with your builds. Now I've shown you guys this before, but it's way back there, and this is mainly for you newer guys getting into this. Now this serves a double purpose, because I send these out with silicone grease. So if it ever starts to not run as good as it used to, you could just take this out and grease it up. And the hole is located right here. It's a nice tight fit. It probably won't even show up on the camera because it's tiny. So you just insert that into it. Hang on, there we go. And it goes all the way down, and you just pump it full of your silicone grease, and you're good to go again. And that prevents you from having to take it apart and retune it. Sometimes I can get out of tune, and what will happen is if your clutch is too tight, the BBs won't make it down and out of here. I'm not really a big fan of the BB centering mod. It just caused me problems and double shots. Excuse me. But anyway, what happens is it pushes BBs up in there so hard that the air can't make it come out of that pocket down and out. Now, on the other hand, if your clutch is too loose, what happens is it will push the BBs down, spinning the clutch, and it will actually venturi BBs out of it. So it could suck up a BB from way down there and push it out. But that BB is not going to come out with very much velocity. And what happens is it'll run rough. And occasionally, the BBs will make it all the way up in there. And that BB will come out full steam ahead and smack into the one of lower velocity in front of it. So that's how to tell if your clutch is too tight or too loose. Now, let's see. The other thing about this is you can actually adjust it to get yourself in the ballpark, and that's between 7 and 9 ounces. And the way you do that is you don't have to get a fancy trigger gauge, but you measure it with this clamp down, because that'll just spin if you don't do this. You just pull on here up top, and I can't do this with one hand, but you're looking for the clutch to break at about 7 to 9 ounces, and that'll get you in the ballpark. Then you can figure out if it's too tight or too loose, and what I do is I adjust it in quarter turns from there on. And yeah, when I tell you what, when those guys were all over me about their guns not working, I felt just like this. But you know what? It's been a long road. And I appreciate all of you guys hanging in there with me and allowing me to do these crazy things that I do with these. And I just feel blessed that I get to share all the cool things that you guys are doing. Like this, Ronald, he just busted 1,100 feet per second. And I'm like, wow, I've never shot that fast. And I'm waiting to hear back from him what PSI. I know I've sold him some 1600 PSI regulators, so that's probably what he did it with. But man, I haven't done that with air. I've just done it with helium. So I'm sure he feels like this guy. All right, guys, I'm going to wrap up this build, and that'll probably be the next video that I post. So I'll see y'all then. Later.